flying hour. Like Neil said, we're going to be here every Thursday in March and April, and we're very excited to bring our show to you. If you've never seen us before, it's kind of interesting. What you're about to see are actors. These actors have memorized scripts like they would for any other play, a play that you might see at the Alley, or at Stages Theater, or at a place where they produce forms of archaic culture. They have memorized these scenes, and they have prepared them like they would for any other type of play they would do. However, they're going to be joined on stage by improvisers who don't know anything about the play that they're doing, anything about the script or the character they're playing, much like you don't know anything about the play that you're about to see, because the death of American theater is all of our fault. That's just that.
Lights come back up. Magical lying out.
I do, but usually it's whiskey.
I was not drunk at all.
I didn't say you were.
I really hope you don't think that, because I totally...
This took a turn for the emotional. No, I didn't say you were drunk, and even if you were...
Is this a problem for you?
No.
Is it, like, important to you that I drink?
No, I would prefer you be here sober.
Because this is something I just can't stand.
Okay. No, full disclosure, I plan on kissing you by the end of the evening, and I'd like you to be of sober mind when I do.
I don't know how I feel about this.
Fair, then I'll take that as a no until you decide otherwise. I have board games if you'd rather.
I just asked for a glass of water, and you're turning this into some major moral issue.
You came back to my home. You were drinking a clear liquid at a bar, alone.
For you to insinuate, like, whatever, that I was drunk or something at that party.
Okay. I'm glad you were sober. I wish that you were twice as sober.
Does it seem like what? Like you could get drunk on water?
Yeah, well, that's true. So it has a dreadfully sobering effect that I avoid at all costs.
Drunk women attractive?
Oh. As a feminist, I'm supposed to say no.
Plain is good. Plain is strong.
Sure.
Water is the strength of the earth. I don't find that plain. I find that inspiring.
Okay, but you just said plain was strong. So I'm really getting mixed signals on the whole.
Oh my god.
Okay. It's a fact. I'm not ashamed of it. But you are. If you think someone allowing you to do something is a hostility, like, you're asking to be taken care of and expecting it.
This is a complete exaggeration.
Okay. That's your opinion. You're becoming less attractive.
Well, you know, I feel like whenever I'm, you know, not doing so well, that people should be more supportive.
Mm-hmm. That is right in line with what I was saying.
Well, you're just being kind of, you know,
I'm standoffish. I'm treating you as an independent human. I did not hear a word of that.
I really object to that because a lot of people treat me like I'm some sort of flake because of the way I look. Yeah, it's just, I don't want to sound like a hideous feminist, but I will not be treated like a stupid person.
You do not sound like a feminist. You sound like an anti-feminist. Like, oh, take care of me when I don't feel well. We should get you back on blog. This is
because I really respect what you're saying, but you know, your friend is just has a lot of angry energy.
Oh, that's true. She's a Nazi priestess.
Which I like.
Sure. It makes for great print.
It's not like I'm saying it's a bad thing that he's married to some screaming woman that always. Obsessed with phone lists and highlighters?
Sure. We all have our hobbies. I have board games and puppets.
I just mean, I don't judge him for being hostile about it.
Sure. He's a good man deep down inside. He's very confused. He thinks that a lot of issues that are about wider society are just about him.
God, no. I'm totally on a diet. Food is, like, disgusting to me.
See, this is that anti-feminist thing. I mean, you have overtly said that it's about, like, enticing male gaze, but, like, a lot of your decorum hints at it.
Oh my God, are you kidding me?
No.
Most of the things that people put in their mouths is just, like, totally like eating death. That's how bad our food is for us.
You're vegan. I mean, I don't want to blame you, but like, you seem very lovable. You seem so safe to love you, which is a rare thing for a woman as beautiful.
So many men are like obsessed, and it's just, I'm very overwhelmed.
Could we focus on one man then, and see if you are less overwhelmed?
I'm from Ohio. It's different there.
I imagine they are into monogamy, and that's what I'm, at least, sexual monogamy for a time, and then if the relationship works, I'm into, this is a nice house, and it's very lonely.
I'm feeling very overwhelmed.
Hey, this is not the time to kiss you. That would be wrong.
Maybe some vodka?
Hey, but for the record, the kissing is still on the... Give me your cup. I forgot your cup. The kissing is still on the table.
I don't know.
But I do. If you ever say no at any point in the night, that's fine. But every drink I give you, I'm going to remind you that I have a goal in mind.